Oops. Wow, you're gonna play and commentate. Good for you, dude.
Yeah, I thought I might do something as well.
Rick?
Yeah?
Rick?
Yes, what's up?
Oh, I just wanted to see if you're still there.
Yeah, I am. Don't worry.
I was worried.
Just trying to get the streams to show up so I can announce it.
Nice job in getting the stream to show up, dude. Did good. Just in time.
Yep.
You got the back position. Good job, Rick.
I don't know, I'm still loading environment.
Color fit. And we're off.
Yep. Looks like it.
It's like we got the GT clan against some other players.
A mixture of some veterans, I guess. At least with Ballin. At least with Yao Ballin, we have a veteran here, I think.
Looks like Solcule is coming up to color fit pretty quickly.
Probably a scout. Nothing too bad yet.
Poland against Ukraine.
Don't forget about me.
It's gonna be our first engagement. Yeah, looks like Colorfit loves those hatmen early in the game to take care of the peasants and early rushers.
Well, they are pretty good, they are strong, have much health. I think they also face ammo, I don't know. I don't play Ukraine.
Oh, now we gotta raid by some Cossacks. I also have Ahmed coming up to support Carlin. Carlin's already engaged with Beppa. Austria is against the Poland and England. It's like the pirates trying to come up on the flank. Like Beppa's taking care of the front. Colorfit's in a bit of trouble over there on the left side.
Yep. I'm not fully with it today, I think.
Got some archers coming in to see if they can destroy some of his buildings. Ricardo's trying to give him the support and drive out the enemy from Colorfit's base. Did a nice job recovering over there. Looks like they're giving in Beppa a 2-on-1. I'm not sure where Pirate is, but he doesn't seem to be helping too much. His teammate. And here he comes. Just hope it's not too late. Beppa's getting some serious damage to his troops and buildings. They're destroying his mines. The archers. Beppa just lost both his town centers and almost lost his blacksmith. On the left-hand side, looks like they're going for position. Back in Colorfit and Ricardo from the north and from the right-hand side. Again, they're using their archers to destroy Colorfit's market. Town centers, blacksmiths. Ukraine, I know Colorfit was practicing in Ukraine yesterday and he said he had it all down pat, so we'll see how it goes. Men are doing a good job on the light infantry and round shears coming from Balin. Cardo's giving some chase to some archers, getting them out of the Colorfit's base. Pirates starting to engage. But he's engaging two enemies at one time, so we'll see how he makes out. Pirate and Beppa don't seem to be on the same page. They seem to be taking turns attacking.
Dragoons as well.
Austria already has their 18th century dragoons going.
It's mercenaries, I think.
Just yes, so the mercenary ones, that's correct. Now, let's see, Carlin and Ahmad are putting both attacking Beppa and Pirate at the same time, so. Now they're coming over and just attacking Beppa. It's like Colorfit's trying to rebuild his base. Getting his diplomatic center back up and running. His one town center, he has his two town centers and a market there, so. Looks like Balin's coming down and attacking Pirate. when Pirate's troops are all over helping Beppa, and they're using the archers to destroy his mines. He's not going to make out very good there. He just noticed it, so he's bringing all his troops back. Could be too late. Colorfit's trying to help with his hatmen. Wow, they destroyed like five mines of pirate. It's like they're coming with archers, light infantry, and round shears and invading pirate. Beppa already called good game, as he was invaded 2-on-1, so he wasn't able to hold out. Looks like Pirate might be able to survive, but not too long once Amon and Carlin come over to the left. Did a lot of damage. Well, Pirate gave up. He's done. All good game. Everybody wants to restart except Rui. Rui wants to continue to play. Of course, the GT clan of Colorfit and Cardo are attacking until it's all over. Never give up, never surrender. Crane's putting up a good battle. Zulkiel already has the cannons coming out. He has the multi-barrel cannons coming out. Some regular cannons. Trying to shoot down those Ukraine from Colorfit. Is Sir Duke's coming. Now, Colorfit just raised the right flag. Looks like we need the fire department over here. All the buildings are on fire.
Almost like in the Amazon.
Can you still hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Looks like we're going to face some Austria spam. With a Swiss as well. My foreseeing talent tells me this is going to be a massive defeat.
I see.
Now they switch in Austria for Hungary. Whether that's better or worse, we don't know just yet.
Yeah, people are still going with Austria even though Colorfit asked them not to.
Well, I guess they just want to win.
Austria, Hungary, and Switzerland's not a bad lineup.
Lineup of power nations. I don't think that's able to be beaten. Except if Pepper goes for Austria.
Yes, he went Austria too.
Now we just have to hope that Pepper is behind or in front of Call of It. Otherwise, that's wasted potential.
Yeah, it looks like Pirates against behind Color Fit this time.
That's not so good. That's bad luck on our side.
Like most people are starting off with the two town centers and the mill.
I haven't heard of anybody who builds an 18th barracks first.
Thank you. Looks like you're also playing with Market. Market, Cannons, and the DC. Cannons. Yeah, so those are options I don't usually choose.
Cannons is a bad, big bad for me. I can't really work with cannons. And as soon as somebody uses cannons, my entire technical superiority is completely gone.
Pirate's already on his way to support Color Fit. Most people are building their DCs from what I can see.
It's a good time for a diplomatic center.
It's like they're already putting some pressure on Color Fit. Like they're putting some pressure on Ricardo too.
Is this an Austria? This is an Austria. I am almost confirmed to be dead.
Austria Rangiers. Up, and he has some archers, mercenary archers. Yep.
Save to the market.
Ah, his peasants are saving his market.
But my army has not been saved.
No, unfortunately not. But you saved your market, lost the townhouse, but saved the market.
Yeah, unfortunately it doesn't really use a lot because I lost my economic output over the for the time.
Peppa's up there putting some pressure. But he's 2-on-1 against Balin and Ahmad. Give you a little time to breathe. Looks like there's a battle over the left. Color Fit's engaging with Carlin and Detrom.
Time to be commanded around by Peppa. Like I just had to reorganize myself a bit.
Yeah, it gives you a break. So looks like you're both combining forces and chasing the enemy back north.
Yeah, he ordered me to do that. I technically would have liked to restructure my rebuild myself a bit, but no upgrades, no problems.
Yeah, Color Fit's moving left and right to try to get the enemy out of his base, but they just keep on coming. They're alternating pushing in and out of his base, so he has to move all his troops from the left to the right. Unfortunately, it leaves an opening as he's chasing him and Pirate are chasing one person out and the other person's entering his base with a bunch of light infantry and round shears. So now they're getting to a lot of the peasants and troops coming out of their buildings.
Through some miracle we've managed to beat the army of Ahmed and Balin. For now at least.
Yeah, so now he's getting attacked from the north, now that all his troops are over to the right. He loves those Hetman, though. They do some damage.
Well, that's a lot of damage. How about a little more?
It's like Beppa's making some good progress over there on Balin's base. It's like he has pretty much taken it over.
My army died for that.
Which looks like his support of Ahmed is coming up, but it might be a little too late, as Beppa is already in the base, and it's like Ricardo is going to be there shortly. He did get to save some of his troops before his base is getting destroyed.
There's dragoons now. From Ahmed.
Yeah. 18th century, the real deal, huh, Ricardo?
No, it's just
the real deal.
It's not that bad if it's just mercenaries. They can be countered. Maybe. Not by me, because I don't have any economy to counter it.
Yeah, you and Beppa definitely took over the base. Pirate and Collarfit are challenging Carlin for his base. Doing a nice job holding off the support of Detrom while attacking Carlin's base. Carlin's blowing up his mines to try to kill some of the troops. Beppa's using his archers to finish off the base. Yeah, it looks like Colorfit and Pyra definitely made a lot of progress in Carlin's base. Detrim's coming over to try to regain it. Pirate's taking his troops and running over to Detrom's base. Collarfit's retreating a little bit, but Pirate's still doing some damage with his archers, killing some mines. Pirate and Colorfit are regrouping back at his base. Detrom and Carlin are chasing. Did a lot of damage to Carlin's base, but they look like they're recovering. Detrom brought his archers and has destroyed a couple of Colorfit's mines. It's like an iron and a gold mine. Detrom's bringing his army up over to the right-hand side and invading the base that way. Be trouble for Collarfit. He's already moving all his peasants. Detrom has some grenadiers destroying townhouses now and mines. Okay, here we go over on the right-hand side. Beppa and Ricardo are attacking. They got done destroying Balin's base, and now
there's to
Ahmed's base.
And Ahmed has cannons.
Looks like I saw a cannon, yeah.
I don't know
don't
why
see any formations saying, with Beppa and Ricardo.
I do know very well what I'm doing.
Who's gonna win that battle? Looks like Ahmed got about four cannons shooting it into Ricardo's army. Problem with that is cannons are gonna run out of iron and coal to fire pretty soon with the damage that Beppa did to the iron and coal mines. All right, now on the left-hand side, we've got a two-on-two. Pelefit and Beppa and Harlan and Detrom are both going at it in Colorfit's base.
It's power.
That held them off, and they're Colorfit's following him with his 18th century mercenaries. If it's moving on the hill. Call if it's moving into Carlin's base a little bit. No, he's teasing him. Playing a little game of faking to go and attack and then pull him back. I think the hill's gonna give Colorfit a pretty significant advantage. Both sides are compressing their troops.
I think in this case, compression is actually getting a bit bad because people are starting to have cannons.
Yeah, I don't see any cannons over on this side, but I agree. pretty Colorfit pretty much took care of Carlin's army. Now he's trying to finish off Detrom's attack. It's like Carlin only has peasants left, and they're moving out. Looks like most of Detrom's infantry and cavalry are disappearing pretty fast too. Here comes a pirate giving them support with his little pikemen or grenadiers. Oh, they're grenadiers, yep. Mercenary grenadiers he made. Oh, he has about 67 grenadiers, so they're gonna be able to take down Carlin's base pretty fast. And they're going to work right away. And it looks like Detrom has cannons now too. So he has about like six that are firing on Colorfit and Pirate as they're demolishing and flattening Carlin's base. See any cannons from Pirate or Colorfit yet. Nah. They're a long way away.
There's multiple cannons from Armored. It's gonna be a disaster.
Yeah, Armored has some multi-barrel cannons over here.
Pepper saved us in that regard. The Wheel of Fortune has been turned over.
Yeah, it looks like you and Pepper are taking on Armored by yourselves, so...
Pepper captured his Mutterberry cannon, so he took some heavy damage like that.
Yeah, capturing them cannons is a quick way to get them. Wow, there looks like there's a lot of cannons there.
I'm also bringing firepower and fully upgraded musketeers.
Whoa, look at all those cannons. I can't tell who's... Yeah, now they're moving.
Ironically, these are my cannons now.
Okay, so you do your thing with the, do some damage with those cannons.
I'm usually the worst person to deal with cannons, whether it's defending or fighting with them. We don't need to sword. This week.
Yeah, Beppa and Ricardo are slowly moving in on Ahmed's base. I don't see Balon anywhere. Even with the use of cannons, you guys are pretty compressed. Learned the other day that Colorfit doesn't do the upgrades for accuracy when he's shooting into infantry and cavalry, only when he's aiming at buildings. Carlin's base, but he's pretty much... Yep, Carlin just called good game. Balon just called good game. Colorfit just called good game. Colorfit and Pirate are going over to finish off Detrom. Yeah, Hey, and Beppa and Ricardo are making some really good progress taking over Ahmad's base too. GT strong. Ahmed quit, blew up all his buildings. Looks like it's gonna be a good game. Fitz yelling for his team to go, go, go.
And my game bugged out.
You did fine.
No, my game bugged out. I have to quit the game.
Oh no.
I started.
Well, hurry up. I'm sure they're gonna have another one.
Yep.
All right, so here we go again. For a zero P on thousands of resources, playing with capture of cannons, DC and market are all on. Switched up the teams a little bit to this game. The GT clan is not all playing together. It looks like they traded one of their members to be on the other side to make, perhaps to make the teams more even. What they call a pro start with the two townhouses, the mill, storage center, and then the blacksmith. However, there is a turkey out there that is going with only one townhouse, a mill, a blacksmith. Detrom's off to the races and producing some round shields already. Yeah, looks like Petro's new to this game, as well as Dries is new. Detrom wandered into Colorfit's base and's now facing the Hetman coming out of his stable.
I hope you know that Petro is a veteran.
Yeah, didn't mean it any other way. I just meant he was new in this game, not that he was like a newbie type of person.
That's true.
This is the first time I've seen him play so far today, so that's what I meant by new.
Okay. All good.
No offense to him or anybody else. I have a great respect for everybody who plays. So. Beppa and Colorfit are teaming up this game. And Ahmed and Petra are teaming up on the other side. Petru. Sol-Kuel is pressure. Petro's base. And there's Colorfit's Hetman coming over to provide some support. He's off the map. So Kuel's doing a quick retreat. Here comes Ricardo in from the other side. Now Sokul's coming back to apply some pressure from the other side. Ricardo made some pretty deep progress into the base there.
And Petru made some progress into me.
And here comes Sokul to provide some support and do some cleanup. Ahmad's coming up, but he might be too late with his light infantry. Nope, Sokyul's retreating and drawing out Petru from his base. Petro decides to return to his base. Looks like Beppa and Colorfit are deciding to go put some pressure on Detrom's base.
I'm pretty much dead at this point.
Oh, that's not good, Rick.
Sokolo decides it's more worth his time to attack into a 2-1 situation.
I see. So yeah, now we got Petro and Ahmad taking on Sokyul both at the same time. And it's making Sokyul retreat to his base. Looks like all their troops are coming out in full force. Sokyul is the Netherlands, how about that?
The power of guns will protect them.
Nope, they're catching up to those guns pretty fast. And they're making some cinches, so they're gonna be able to take them out even faster. Peppa and Colorfit are doing a pretty good number on Dree's Detrom. For an added measure, the Hetmen are coming in. Yeah, Ahmed has made it all the way to base. Looks like there's some Turkey Tartars doing some damage to all the mines. Why Sokyul's attacking the light infantry. Like Petru is heading up a little north, up until Rick's base to see what's going on. Beppa and Colorfit are pushing. Getting some more parrot. Dreeds and Detrom are both retreating back to Detrom's base, but looks like Rick successfully scared off Petru from attacking. No cannons yet from either side. We're only 12 minutes into the game, so it's a bit early to see the cannons. Ahmed has assembled quite the army so far. Colorfit and Beppa are coming for another round. Colorfit and Beppa are now gonna decide to attack together, I think.
Apparently armor does dirt.
Yeah, I don't know what that means.
That's not healthy, just not dirt.
I don't know. I'll have to do an interview with him after the game and find out what that means. Bappa's producing some 18th century cavalry that are mercenaries. Go help Carlin until he ran into Ahmad's massive army. Ahmad's Turkey, so he has some light infantry, Tartars, and some grenadiers. All going toward Sukul's base.
I managed to smash Petra's army. Without any fully upgraded pipes.
The Tartars are immediately going after the mines. Carlin counters with some cinches to see if he can kill all the Tartars before they destroy his whole base. Here comes Collarfit to add some support, see if he could cut off some of them. Heading over to Carlin's base. Beppa's retreating. From Dries' base, he was in a full-on attack, and now he's moving into more of a defensive position in Colorfit's base. Ahmed's still destroying the mines. Detrom and Jeeves are getting to attack Colorfit's base, right on the edge. Look like there's some Sir Dukes in formation. Got some Rangers, Grenadiers are Colorfit's mines as they push Beppa back. Where Beppa was trying to hold down Colorfit's base while he was helping out over on the right-hand side. They destroyed Colorfit's DC. Continued to push Beppa back. Color is fighting with Rick's mounting a charge coming down from the south to help out. Looks like it's mainly Ahmad's army who's fighting. Well, Petru, I see some big ones in there. Colorfit's base is pretty much flattened. Someone's gonna have to help him regain his base. Rick's doing a good job taking out the light infantry. like the massive number of yellow soldiers is going to be a little too much for everybody to handle. Trees and Detrom are still working very close together to push Peppa all the way back to his base. Still no cannons in this game, and it's 20 minutes in, and I still don't hear any cannons. Peppa looks like he's on his last stand here, so... Harlan calls good game.
Another has cannons.
Yeah, as a true GT clansman, Rick is to the end. Now they're coming for Rick's base. Unfortunately, there's not too much he's going to be able to do. Like this is Rick's last stand. I see a cannon coming. Unfortunately, I think the number of enemy is gonna take over Rick's base. If it's still producing units. Ah, there, he just called good game. Massive number of yellow units in this game. I don't know how he made so many units.
Well, he's lucky. He only has to... And I think the infantrymen only take a second to build.
Yeah, those light infantry guys come flying out. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Stallman just entered the lobby. Great, unbelievable.
Now we have an extremely low tier player in this. Awesome. I'm sure Call of Duty is very... yeah.
Yeah, I always thought about the idea how to rotate these players. I always think that, like, a losing team should always have to sit out one and let somebody else have a chance. It's obviously not my lobby, but just an idea.
Well, for me, it's gonna be the last game.
Yeah, it's just like the fourth one, isn't it?
Yep. I'm getting... I was already bought before. So there is something awesome where everything seems boring.
I always have to get my little dig in there. Definitely have a very talented lobby this time. It's like the who of Cossacks 3. Here we go. Looks like game four. Have a pretty long stream today. And it's 4-on-4. Thousands resources. Playing with the market in DC. Zero peace time. I don't know, is it me or does Dries always play on the opposite team of all the other GT players?
I don't know. I see him too rare to judge that.
Rick got a front row seat today, huh?
Nah, I don't enjoy that.
Yeah, I didn't think you did. I don't enjoy it either, but that's why I mentioned it. It's a hard position to defend and hold down. Luckily for you, Beppo is on his way to support you, so hopefully that will help out.
Certainly better help than Ahmed last game. Or was it Ahmed? No, Sokolo was it?
Yeah, Sokolo was your neighbor, yeah, that didn't help out.
Yeah. I keep getting people mixed up for some reason. It's just
no, that's alright. I hear you. I always have to look at the colors and stuff too, so.
Yeah. For me, it's just my incredible high-tech and high-tier memory, which doesn't delete itself after 5 seconds.
Antone's already putting pressure on Ricardo. And goes Ricardo with his Scottish pikemen. Who probably are no match for Antone's pikemen who are retreating.
Toko has more upgrades than me, so I took more losses, but I have the home advantage for now. I am having the home plate.
Well, Beppa's coming to support you, so hopefully that's gonna give you some additional pikemen.
Well, hopefully, because Antoha keeps going around me.
Yeah, here comes Petro is coming through.
That's not good.
Yeah, he had some archers there, huh?
They seem to know that they haven't died, but Beppa manages to defend me.
And Beppa has some light infantry and pikemen coming. Petru attacked with mostly archers. And goes Russia on the other side. Looks like they already had a form.
No, they just have a lot of units.
Stallman putting some pressure on Arturo. He has everything. Here's the pikemen, some round shears, archers. He's come fully prepared. Stallman's looking for an area to attack. Putting his archers on one of the Cossack houses. Got that. It means retreating. Hellefit's now taking charge from the other side. Now he's retreating. Here comes Stallman from the right, catching all the stragglers. Get caught up and moving to the other side. Looks like Stallman's going all in. Stallman took out a gold mine, penetrated his base all the way to the mill. Here comes Colorfit with his favorite Hetman. A lot of action over here on the right hand of the screen. And there goes DC.
And Peppa is doing questionable actions.
Yeah, I don't know why. He seemed to be waiting there for a little bit. He had a pause. Now he's attacking.
Too late. Now I have to
spend too late.
A lot of resources.
Gone.
So I just erect another one.
I guess Colorfit and now Stallman did a number on Antone's base. It's like Beppa's retreating.
For some reason, I don't know why.
Now he's coming forward. There goes your DC again after he just rebuilt it.
This is some kind of sick joke.
Come and help out with his Cossacks and Hetman.
This time I can't rebuild it. Now I'm stuck without the DC.
Wow, Colorfit's really providing the support now.
The trick with the Hetman is that they have when they one shot a unit with one attack, they can instantly attack another one, which makes them basically get a chainsaw if they can kill the unit in one swing. But if they have to strike a unit twice, they get very ineffective.
Yeah, they're a killing machine, that's for sure. But they're a slow build time, that's for sure.
And expensive.
Yeah. Beppa Colorfit, or... attacking down in the lower left-hand corner. Stallman again, attacking on the right hand side. Taking the enemy on 2x2 for 1. That might be a questionable battle in color. Doing a pretty good job of eliminating. Anton's coming over to help out. Now it's pretty much on the right. Solomon's just rolling down south, clearing a path. I don't know if Anton has any peasants left.
Oh, I can finally rebuild my diplomatic center.
There goes, yeah, it's getting erected for the third time.
Hopefully this time for a bit longer.
Petru's pretty much down. I think pretty much eliminated all his army. He's like it's coming to finish him off.
He liberated himself with some dragoons. But it shouldn't be too much of a problem for the Serdiops.
Dries is making a push against Stallman. Stallman has troops lined up then shortly. Yeah, here come Beppa and Colorfit to finish off Petra.
There's a lot of towers going up in the base of Antocha.
Oh yeah, look at all those towers. Might be time to bring the cannons out.
I'm way too poor for that.
Let somebody else do the cannons, huh, Rick?
Yep. Besides, they can use them better than I. And now Peppa just abandoned me. Awesome. I like losing my army for no reason.
A lot of grenadiers over there.
They're useless against dragoons.
Wow, they were mowed down.
Yep.
Definitely not a match. Petro buildings. Anton and Arturito are left in the middle for Colorfit and Beppa to take care of, and Stallman is moving in over on Dries' base over on the right hand side. did finish a lot of the towers.
Yep.
Not all of them.
He had a lot of time.
Did some upgrades. No, he quit.
It's game over.
Dries is using his peasants to as one last final stand against Stallman. Made Stallman retreat, however, he doesn't have too much of an economy left or any troops left, so.
At least now we know who's the better Pole.
Okay, here come Beppa and Collarfit to finish off Dries.
No, we are. The team seems to agree that Starman should attempt to kill Zeez.
Yeah, you gonna hold your ground and let him see if he could finish off Dries by himself?
I doubt it.
Sometimes they do that. It's like a game within a game, instead of interfering on a 3-on-1. No, Dries retired. He didn't want to go through it.
Oh, well. He took pity on Starman, indeed.
Yeah.
He didn't want to make him suffer.
He took pity on Stallman. Yeah, he didn't want to show Stallman up, so he retired. Good for him. Glad there's some sportsmanship left in this game. That's awesome. Yeah, I made it into the room without having to ask somebody to get kicked. That's fantastic. Union Mike. Welcome to the stream, Union Mike. Yeah, Dries did a pretty good job.
He showed Starman who's the better Pole. That's a good enough job.
Players. Color's gonna make a choice. I think Union Mike's the newest one, and Stallman joined last game. Really mixed up the teams with the GT clan this time. All right, we're on to game five. For those who are just joining us, we're doing four versus four, zero piece time, cannons on, playing with the DC and market. Starting off with two townhouses, town centers, going for the mill and the blacksmith, and the storehouse. Seems like people are later in the games as they go on, or chatting more or playing less. Move on to the market and the two barracks, 17th century barracks. Most people are going to be pushing out the pikemen. Like color fits in love with Ukraine today. Must be Ukraine Day.
I'm sure Barton has his fingers in that.
Pirate and Ricardo are already up, pushing units up to support their allies. Colorfit's already pushing out his favorite hetman. A lot of Poland and Ukraine in this match. And Bavaria. Colorfit's already causing some confusion with his hetman. Up in our Torito's base. Torito doesn't seem to be too worried pushing his army south to attack Colorfit. And a surprising move. Stallman's going straight south to put the pressure on Anton, who's over there trying to help our attack Arturito. Stallman with his archers has already destroyed a gold mine. Not sure Arturito even knows he's there yet. There he does. Now he's starting to move his troops over. And again, Toe is right in the middle of Colorfit's base, causing Colorfit to take his peasants and move them off to the side. the Hetmen are doing their damage, but there's only so many of them. It's like Rick and Peppa are teaming up over there on So Cool. Everybody's playing with their archers to kill the mines. Here's Rick attacking. Not sure what happened to Beppa again, but Rick's putting the pressure over on Soulcule by himself with his pikes and light infantry as Scotland, and they do a pretty good job. Peppa decides to go over and start putting some pressure on Stallman.
No, he just waited for me to die or so, I don't know.
I was trying to be nice, Rick. I was just trying to be nice.
Just the facts.
Yeah, it could be. I'm just calling it as I see it. You know, he's going over to attack Stallman, so... could be other things that are going on, but that's what I see. Antone's attacking Arturito. Colorfit's defending against one of his clanmates, Pirate. Where are those Hatmen? Hatmen take care of everything.
The Ukraine has arrived. This side, at least.
Oh boy. Stallman has made it to Rick's. He has some Serdukes shooting with some light infantry. And Deppa's garden, Rick's garden is base. Rick's pretty effectively taking care of those Serdukes and pikemen. Yes, we all know Colorfit loves his Hetmen. 11 Hetmen have 260 kills. Antone is destroying Arturito's base with Colorfit. Pretty much pushed them out, so he's retreating back to Stallman's base to start over. Rick is following Stallman all the way back to base. Beppa's decided to go put some pressure on Soulcule. Antone's coming up the middle to hopefully attack some of Stallman's troops. Nope. Antone's going over to help Colorfit. Put some pressure on Pirate. Stallman decides to come back and try again with attacking Rick and Beppa. After he sees Rick's army, he decides to retreat. Anton and Colorfit are slowly making their way north to take on Pirate, who has pikemen and light infantry lined up. Rick's attack. Those pipes are in light infantry of the Scottish are hard to stop. Dappa and Sokul are look like they have a standoff.
Managed to outplay Starman, and most of his Zodiac forces seem to have died.
Yeah, it looks like Anton's gonna start taking on an Arturito, who doesn't have much of an army left. Rick's going back to his base to assist Beppa against Sokul. Looks like Rick got there just in time to help Beppa. I think with the strength of those Scottish pikemen, they're gonna be okay to save Beppa's base. Yes. Look at that. Beppa was lucky Rick retreated and came back. He took care of that. Rick's continuing to chase and push. Colorfit's cinches and his Cossack surdukes. And it looks like Beppa's almost done. Yeah, Beppa called good games. Colorfit said easy. Looks like Rick's taking care of Sokul by himself.
No, Beppa's still here.
Yeah, there goes Rick into Sokul's base. Destroying everything in sight. I think there's a couple Beppa's men in there somewhere.
We have one.
Aha! Chris BG's here. Good for him. One more, Colorfit says. Boy, he's rocking today. He almost has that Ukrainian nation down pat. I think he's going to go all Hatton in this game.
I already had my one more game.
Yeah, I know. I think you stayed one longer than you said. So it looks like he'll have some people to fill in. But thanks for playing, and we'll see you next week.
Yeah, thanks. My game just bugged out again anyway.
Okay.
Well done. I'm going to be on my way then. And thanks for taking me up. And thanks for watching.
Problem.
Until next time. Adios.